Dennis Hoff, owner of the ranch, and 6 more Nevada brothels.
We've got it right. The rest of the world's got the problem. Move over and let this American show you how the sex business should be done, where it's clean, it's respectful, safe for the customers, safe for the girls, safe for health reasons.
Well, if it's so great, this system, why is it only in Nevada?
Well, because politicians can't deal with it. Well, in the next election cycle, your opponent's going to say, John Jones loves prostitutes, hookers. I don't like him. I'm the family values guys.
Yet Hoff himself is now running for the state assembly on a Republican ticket in November. He pledges to uphold citizens' rights to guns, water, and low taxes. And he's got widespread support, including, strangely enough, from evangelical pastors. But not all the locals are impressed.
I would say that a pimp does not speak for me. And I'm tired of that mentality.
Brenda Sandquist, a churchgoer and charity worker, is part of a group called the End Trafficking and Prostitution Political Action Committee. They started a petition in Lyon County to get a question put on the ballot in the midterm elections. Should the legal brothels there be allowed to continue?
It used to be okay to bring slaves from Africa, and someone finally had the courage to say, no, we're not going to have slavery. This is just a different kind of slavery. They are slaves.
Up the road, Melissa Holland, a fellow activist who runs a refuge for abused women, says well-paid sex workers like Alice Little are not representative.
The vast majority of women that have been prostituted are consistently telling the stories of rape, sexual assault, oppression, degradation, violence against women. And so what we're talking about in Nevada is, do we create a policy around the rare minority of privileged women that say this is really choice?
Ironically, in the internet age, choice might decide this battle. These days, the real money is in online porn and Nevada's illicit sex trade.